Good morning, my dear friends. I am Prashant Mavani and I warmly welcome all of you to StudyIQ. I hope you all are doing good. Today is Sunday and I believe you all are enjoying your Sunday. Apart from that, we also have Gudi Padwa. Navratri has just started from today. So let me first of all wish all of you, greet all of you for this festival season. God bless all of you, right? And may you achieve whatever, may you get the strength to achieve what you are aspiring for. With this, dear friends, StudyIQ provides pen drive and tablet courses. We will talk about it because the Navratri sales are on at present. You get very good discount on our pen drive and tablet courses. You can see we offer UPSC courses. We have optional courses of UPSC defense exams and SSC bank, state level exams, KVS, and we have CLAT and other exams. Your prelims are not far. And we have got our test series out there for you as well. You get discount on this test series as well because of this Navratri sale. So make the most out of it. And before I forget, dear friends, you can download this lecture from my Facebook page. You can get in touch with me. You can follow me. You can contact me as well. And let's start our day with this bus. Now, you'd be thinking how we can start something with this outdated, worn out bus. Of course, it requires new engine oil. It would require good brakes, right? It fuel tank and other things. Its windscreen and many things needs a good touch of mechanic. Now, imagine that we are passenger of this bus. Now, you can easily assume that we would be very late, say, for example, to our workplace if we are traveling every day on this bus. And now one day we decide that let's do something about this bus. And what we decide, what we think, or what our solution is, that we get a new driver. Now, this new driver is a bit more efficient. He knows a little bit about bus, bit better than what we used to have. And because of him, we have this less breakdowns. We are facing the rates regarding this breakdown has gone down a little bit, and things are working a bit properly. But do you think we would be able to change our situation? Means, of course, the driver will try his level best to make it as smooth as possible, but we cannot say that we will fix this thing. Now, you would be wondering why I'm talking about this bus and driver and all this stuff. You can compare or take this bus as our country and the new driver as our prime minister. What we are doing here, and for a very long period of time in our country, and generally speaking you find in different countries as well, this is part of human nature. What we do is we leave everything on one leader to fix all our problems, right? And that's what we are doing with Mr. Modi as well. Yeah, but we know that when he came to power at that point of time, we had this very positive vibe. It was there out there in the street. People were expecting so much from Mr. Modi ji, and he's trying his level best. I must say, I'm not saying that he's not doing anything at all. He's trying his level best. As I told you, that this driver is a bit more efficient. He knows things about this bus or how to run country. He has good amount of experience. But then as well, we find this sort of things, isn't it? Banks, right? We see NPAs are going on. Banks are being cheated here and there. You find inefficiency in particularly our public sector banks. See the situation of farmers. Even today, they are relying on minimum support price and their suicides are going on. This sort of things, right? I'm just giving you a big picture. Then you ask middle class segment, they will tell you that taxes are too high. Aadhaar has become a sort of obsession for the government. CBI even today is considered as a caged parrot. And then you have this Lokpal. We don't have a Lokpal. We have just a law on a paper. We don't have a proper Lokpal. We have Lokayuts, and look at their situation. We see someone entering into Lokayut's office and they are being stabbed, and we don't have a Lokayut at national level. Graduates, millions of us, right, have graduated from many different colleges and universities, but when it comes to jobs, are we able to create that many jobs for us? No. And then comes this supremacists, right? They are getting bolder and bolder. These people who are protesting and using violence and giving out threats and so-called cow vigilance and other people, we see that their rise is also taking place. But that does not mean that Modi ji is not doing anything. There are some positive bits that I would like to present here. Like in terms of foreign policy, we are doing absolutely brilliant, right? We have placed ourselves as a leader on the world map. Things have changed a lot. In fact, if you ask NRIs, they are feeling very proud about India. Earlier on, they used to feel a bit of shame about our country, because many a times when you knock the doors of your high commission or your embassies, then you find that help is not available over there as well. So this sort of things were very depressing and embarrassing for our NRIs and other people. Then stock markets, they are doing very well, right? Indian stock markets are doing, means if you ask someone who is in stock market, then you will find that they have done really well, right? From last many years since Modi came into power. Then you have this economic growth is doing very well. Of course, during this demonetization, whilst introduction of GST, we faced some glitches, which is very common thing. It is very natural, right? You find when you are introducing something new, then there are high chances that you will face some sort of difficulties. But anyways, now if we focus on what government has done after these problems, then we find it has tried, it means it has left no stone unturned to sort out this problem of GST. And GST is going to be beneficial for us in longer term. If you go through the reports of World Bank, IMF, and then Standards and Poor, and Moody's and other ones, then everyone is indicating this thing that in future, near future, economic growth is going to be very good in our country. Swachh Bharat, at least I would say personally that at least it has created a bit of awareness. It is altogether a different thing whether we are acting it or not. Yesterday I was out there on the road and I saw a very luxurious car, right? And I saw a small child from that luxurious car. He just chucked away a packet of wafer out on the street. So this is the case. It's not about poor localities, or it is not about just reach. It is about awareness. Yes, people are a bit aware, but when it comes to action, we are still missing this thing. So far so good. You have both sides of coin in front of you, right? And now I would like to talk on seven items, and the reason why I'm discussing this seven different areas that can help us, of course good driver helps, but if we fix these seven areas, then we can change many things. I'm not saying that everything, means it is not just a magic wand, but slowly we will find a big change, you can say, in our country or the way things are going on. And this 7 points will help you a lot in your capacity building. It will help you with your mains examination. It will help you with your studies as well. You will come to know the things that are important for you. So next time when you are reading something on the internet or newspaper or your books, if you come across this 7 points, then I will reckon you to pay attention to all those things, and you should have a good understanding of all these 7 areas. I'll give you a big picture. Let's move ahead. The first one is civil services. Now, most of you are preparing for civil services examination, and I'm sure you know many things about civil services, how you are this exam process and other things. So I'm not going into all those details, but I would like to point out some problems that we find. Even today, you find this VIP culture is there, right? Many of you, I'm not blaming any of you, right? If I would be in your place, then I would be attracted to this, you know, red beacon car and other things. Nowadays they are gone, but still you have that number plates, or this big boards in your car saying that secretary or government of India or etc. So a VIP culture is still there. Even today, you know, even an educated person will find it a bit difficult. He or she will hesitate whilst approaching our commissioners or, you know, deputy collectors and other people. We have very good people, but still we are missing this bridge. We have not created or built this bridge that is connecting citizens directly with our administrators. And more on top, we have to change not just the word, but their behavior, or this whole structure and culture of work when it comes to civil services. We don't need administration now. We need management. We need managers. We don't need administrators. We need good managers. So things are changing. New blood is coming up, or adding new change in civil services. But still, there are many issues like promotion, say, for example. It works on your age, not on your performance. Then you have this many a times you are sidetracked if you are politicians, and their interference is too much nowadays. We find this political pressure. This is something we can expect it in different setups, but it should not be something that refrains or creates, you know, a situation where our civil servants are not able to take any sort of decisions at all. So There are many things that you can change here. There is no appraisal system. Just your senior is looking after your annual confidential report rather than your juniors. The best practice is your juniors should tell like whether you are performing well or not, because they are the ones who are directly working with you, not your boss. In front of your boss, you would be in your best behavior, but your true face is something your masks are removed when you are working with, or if you ask your subordinate. So there are many changes that we need to do here. So this are important, some of big pictures or big points. Then comes, let's go to banks, PSU banks. You know the very situation very well. We have talked about it many a time, so I will be very brief here. NEMO, that is Nirav Modi and Mallya cases, are growing every day, right? Many things are coming out. A couple of days ago, RBI said that RBI is not empowered. It is not having any sort of power to control this. Public sector banks, it can have thoroughly, means solid control on private banks. But still, we are missing this thing. We need to create this situation where this private banks are competing with or our public banks. They should be in direct competition with private banks, not in terms of size, but in terms of their performance and services. So this is a thing that we need to change. And the reason why banks are important, very basic thing, without money, without a smooth flow of money, right? Your all decisions, your whole economy may come down. We need loans at a very reasonable rates. If you go to ASEAN countries and some other countries, you find that loan rates or interest rate is very cheap over there. Here it is very expensive. So this sort of things finally add up to your final product, and then your product export product or your products that you are trading in with in world market will become a bit expensive, and then we will lose with this ASEAN countries. So more business will go over there rather than coming into our country. So I hope this thing is clear. Now moving on to agriculture, we know the situation very well. Farm loan waiver is creating a very bad culture of bad debt. Farmers, now what they think is, most of the farmers, I'm not saying yet that everyone is doing this thing, but many farmers now, they have this bad habit that take the loan from the bank and you don't have to pay it, right? At the change of guard, or when you have election, or when new government will come in, definitely to please all of us, they will give us farm loan waiver. So this is creating a very bad culture. The other thing is that farm loan waivers, they help only medium or large farmers, small and marginal farmers. Even today, a big chunk of their loan is coming from private finances, so it is of no help. Around the world at present, there is a big boom of this organic products and fresh and natural foods and other things, right? If you see our traditional way of agriculture or farming, you find we have always been organic here, right? Traditional way of farming is in fact organic. This was our strength, but now we are using more and more chemicals. There are some good examples, like Sikkim is a state that is famous for farmers for organic farming. It is the first state to be declared as entirely organic farming state in our country. And you make huge amount of money. Trust me, you make huge amount of money. You can charge extra money for being organic. And Western countries, they are looking for this type of foods. We have this potential, but even today, we are not able to grab this opportunity. So there are many other things that we can do about it. Technology, irrigation facility, then you can add this private sector participation. If you go to other countries and if you read the reports and other things, then you find that over there, you have big businesses, right? This big business houses like McDonald's, it is purchasing land from or leasing land from many farmers and government, and then they are basically growing these potatoes, and then they make the fries out of these potatoes, and they are making. So this is just one example. There are other companies who deal with just wheat or rice and other things, so then they process it. So it is a big business. So we need private sector participation in this thing. Ease of doing business, you know it very well. Even today, there are some good examples, no doubt, but still, at grassroots level, you have to go through many different desks. And for big businesses, everything means you have your secretaries and other powerful people. They will look after big companies and big businesses. But when it comes to small businesses, even today, you have all this lengthy processes and bureaucratic red tape and other things. Education system, we know it very well. We talked about RT E, Hindi lecture is out. If you want to check that one out, if you are comfortable with only English, then this RTE will be out soon, right? As soon as I find a slot, I will air it for all of you guys. So, education system, R&D, research and development, we are very behind in we are lagging basically in it. Career counseling, you don't find it in our schools. We see this condition of our public schools and public colleges and things like that, and we see more and more private colleges, and things are becoming more and more expensive in terms of education. So this is something, even today, RTE, right to education, as you cannot miss on paper, it is about education for all, but in reality it is ruining our education system. Anti-corruption body, we don't have this Lokpal, it is all about barking, it is no bite, we haven't seen any sort of bite yet. Lokpal is not appointed yet. Then we find the CBI, even today it is considered as a cage. But remember the case of Rakesh Astana, and then you had this Ranjit Sinha, he's of course a tainted person, but Rakesh Astana was alleged to be involved in corruption and things like that, then as well he was there. So this sort of things goes on. And judiciary, very important pillar of our democracy, isn't it? Without proper, efficient, effective judiciary, what we find is nowadays there is a bit of confidence in the criminals as well. They know it very well that if they slap someone or stab someone, it will take ages and ages to prove this thing. If you have money, then you can have multiple adjournments and other things, right? We are having huge this vacuum of vacancies, means vacuum created by these vacancies at all different levels. In apex court as well, we have vacancies in high courts, as well as we have vacancies in this lower courts as well. So this is one of the reason, this is not only, but one of the reason why we have this many pending cases. Then you need a touch of modern technology, you need well-trained human resources and other things. So these are the seven areas. This is a special discussion that I thought I should add here, because on regular basis we do talk about important editorials and other things, isn't it? On Sundays you don't have editorials, so I thought let me give it a go, and if everyone is okay with this thing, then I can continue this sort of discussion, one topic a day, one topic every Sunday, for your mains, for your overall capacity, that will guide you and direct you what you should read and what are the things that are important. I'll try my best to do this thing. Now moving on to news item, we don't have that many news, but we have many important items in terms of environment, in terms of new species and other things. So let's quickly go through it. Basically, Directorate of Revenue Intelligence, DRI, has finally closed an investigation that was going on against this Harley and Davidson motorcycle. Many of you would be a big fan of Harley and Davidson motorcycles. They are good, no doubt, but it was alleged that they are involved in this evasion of import duty. So this whole investigation was Suomoto conducted by DRI. Now remember, they don't have to ask anyone, they can initiate an investigation if they find that something fishy is going on around. But the good thing is everything is fine, nothing is wrong with this Harley Davidson. They are paying their right amount of tax and other things. So finally DRI has closed this case. It is in news because of USA and Indian relationship. Now let me tell you one thing, and then we'll talk about this USA India relationship. Union budget reduced the rate of this semi-finished complete build, you know, units like your engines and gears and everything. You get it in one piece, or it is already built, and then you add other items like wheels and other things are assembled here. So this sort of items, this sort of motorcycles, they used to be attract 30% of import duty, but now it is 25%, so 5% reduction. Now Trump is not happy about it. Trump wants some more reduction. In fact, he's arguing for 0% import duty. Now you have this troubles going on between India and USA for a very long period of time as far as trade and bilateral relationship is concerned. Remember this thing that when Mr. Trump was pitching for Indian help in Afghanistan, he said that you are making billions of dollars from trade with USA, so you should help Afghanistan. India said that it is not that we are not making money. Yes, we do, but at the same time you make enough money as well. So this sort of small little bit of conflict is it's not a matter of concern, right? We have good people both sides, in both sides they can sort out this thing. And you find when a country, like India and USA, when if you see their overall relationship, then you can see it is quite, the spectrum is quite wide. You feel if you can see many multiple colors in it, so you may find a little bit of problems here and there, but we have to observe this thing from this perspective, like how ready we are to sort it out. And I think both the countries are very much concerned, and both the countries are ready to discuss and talk. So nothing to worry about. And then you have this picture, you can go through it, important bits and pieces we have already discussed. This is just this whole Harley and Davidson case, how it all started, and you have basically a timeline in front of you. Now Pakistan and India, when we talk about relationship, it could be a multi-spectrum relationship, but it is very aggressive, and you know, it is very rigid. You have many big walls, Chinese walls, that are separating India and Pakistan. Anyways, we are going to have this WTO ministerial meeting from tomorrow in our country, Delhi. Right, it is going to take place in Delhi. Many delegates from different parts of the world are here for attending this WTO meeting. Pakistan has said that it is not going to take part in it because of this diplomatic problems that are going on, or spat that is going on between both these countries. From last 1 month, we are observing this thing that many times Pakistan, India is blaming Pakistan that it is being very aggressive and intimidating our officials over there, and similar thing is being said by Pakistan. So this verbal tug of war is on. But here what I would like to draw your attention at is WTO ministerial meeting. We will find editorials, articles and many news items, updates on this thing, very important thing that is going to take place from tomorrow. Now you have this floating boat in Loktak Lake. If you don't know where Loktak Lake is, it is in Manipur. It is very unique lake, and this particular item is very unique as well. You have many important bits and pieces here that will help you with your MCQs and your understanding, so pay attention to this one. Now the motorboat that you can see on your screen is not an ordinary motorboat. It is basically a floating laboratory. You have four women researchers. They are using this motorboat here, and they are conducting this study on this Loktak Lake. Loktak Lake, as I told you, is a very special lake. Now, so far, everyone talks about this carbon dioxide levels, but nitrogen pollution is a major silent threat, has been said by the director of this project. Now, already there are signs of calcium anomalies basically, and in basically you have this calcium, getting too much calcium here, and this is damaging this aquatic life here. I think it is too much, but basically anomalies basically means you have problems with calcium here, and this is destroying this aquatic life here. And it is something similar to coral bleaching. Remember last week on Sunday's analysis, we talked about coral bleaching, and there were important updates regarding it. So what this coral bleaching does with your sea and oceans, this calcium thing does the same thing with your soft water, or you can say this freshwater lakes and other things. Now in this Loktak Lake, you have this Fumdis are basically floating islands. Yes, they are floating islands, and these islands are made of a mix of vegetation, soil and coalesce to form a thing, right? They coalesce to form a thick mat that for centuries have hosted huts and fishing settlements. If you go on a Google and things, then you will find pictures of this Fumdis, and they're very interesting. You find small villages on this Fumdis, like a small, you know, few huts are there, and fishing community is living over there. And this is a very unique thing about this Loktak Lake. So many a times you may find questions where you find this Loktak Lake, in which state, then Fumdis are basically what, they are made up of what. So everything is covered here. Moving on to another item coming from Prime Minister. During this Krishi Unnati Mela 2018, whilst addressing the people who were gathered under this umbrella of Krishi Unnati Mela, Prime Minister talked about this confusion that is being spread on MSP. Basically, you know, opposition parties and other people are spreading wrong things about this minimum support price. Now, Prime Minister has said that all your input costs will be covered, will be taken on board, and then on top of that, you will be given MSP. So, your care will be taken. So, it's not that government is not going to pay you. This has been clarified by Prime Minister. And when it is coming from Prime Minister, then we can bank on this thing. The other thing is, he also talked about not burning this crop residue. You have special lecture, a special video lecture on this thing, stubble burning case. Then you, Prime Minister also talked about grow more oil seeds. We have talked about oil seeds in PIB analysis many a times. So if you are following regular basis, if you are following my PIB analysis, then you'd be aware about this thing. If not, and if you are preparing for UPSC or other government exams, like many current affairs, it's means I know students or aspirants preparing for UPSC, they follow this PIB analysis, but they are short and sweet, 15 minutes max, 20 minutes many a times. And when you have this 20 minute lecture, then most of the time, right, means of course why it is 20 minute lecture sometimes, because there are some important things that we discuss that we cannot leave for tomorrow or for some later on day. So many times you find, but on an average, 15 minutes video is, I think, if someone is saying that I don't have 15 minutes to watch a video, then imagine, right, means step in my shoe. I have to make the videos. If I have time to make videos, to collect all this important data, to analyze it, and then present it to you. And if I'm saying that I can watch 1 hour video every day, right, then if you are saying 15 minutes, so this is all part of, you know, our own mental strength, how much we are ready to walk that extra mile. And I know that if you walk 15-20 days, if you are following one thing, then you will find time for it once you know the importance of the thing. So here we have took a bit of break, but I would like to inform all of you that if you are preparing for other exams, then you will find current affairs that you don't find in Hindu. Right, too many times things, it's not that, of course, you know, there is a plus and minus thing of every newspaper. Hindu is a good quality newspaper, but that does not mean that everything is covered on regular basis in a Hindu newspaper. So there are many items that are like the 7 points that we discussed today. It's not part of Hindu, right? It's not an article that we discussed from Hindu, but so these are the things. So we do cover up in this PIB. So oil seeds, right? The reason why he has said that grow more oil seeds is because we have to import oil from other countries, right? The cooking oil and other things. But we have potential to produce and be self-sustain in this oil seed. And it is part of our human, means this Indian dietary, right? We use oil and other things. And when it is expensive, when we are importing it, of course, it is going to be expensive. So this is many times becoming out of reach to this poor people. And cut urea consumption. We need more organic farming and things like that. Now, rugs and shawls from Kashmir are very famous, particularly this pashmina, right? You get this pashmina wool from pashmina goat. And this is a beauty of Kashmir, basically. 120 delegates and 16 from 16 different countries, they came here. And remember, when your delegates are coming, basically they are brand ambassadors from different countries, and they have good contacts within the business community in their country. So when they are visiting pashmina, when they are visiting Kashmir and looking for, when they are going through all these handmade pashmina items and other artisan items from Kashmir, they will take these brochures and pictures and other things, and it will be it is basically putting Kashmir and its handicraft art on a global map. So this is a big platform here. Turkey was the biggest group, and then you have group from Australia, as far as Mexico and Turkmenistan and other places, Arabic world, Egypt and Lebanon and other countries. It will boost tourism, no doubt. And for last 2 years, we were not able to set up this buyer's seller platform because of disturbance that was going on, but now things are getting there. We are getting there slowly. Pashmina is famous because it is light, it is fine, and it is very warm. And then you have this touch of art on it, and then you find it becomes beautiful. With this, dear friends, another small bits and pieces. SpaceX, this Falcon 9 created a small hole in Earth's upper atmosphere, which temporarily disturbed this GPS navigation, and it is caused by a circular acoustic shock wave. So it is because of this shockwave, you find this sort of hole. But everything is fine now. This is just a small GK thing. This one is about Morocco in terms of archaeology. This is the second major achievement of Morocco in 1 year. And this oldest nuclear DNA is found from this Morocco, from Africa, is found from Morocco. Then you have this tiny little pocket monkeys. They are called pocket monkeys because they are very tiny, 6.5 inch max tall they are. So in your palm as well, you can place them. So they are very tiny. It's not just a picture is small. Yes, they are very tiny monkeys, and their speech, right, the complexity of human speech stands out compared with animal calls, which are considered simpler and repetitive. But a new experiment indicates that marmoset, they are known as marmoset monkeys, they are known as pocket monkeys as well. So this marmoset calls may actually be part of string of sequential segments like words in human language. Now I would like to draw your attention here on this endangered species. They are endangered, and you find them naturally in this western Brazil and basically in South America, but here you find them in zoos, and they are sadly people trade in them. So this is one of the reasons why they are hunted and their natural life is disturbed. Maharashtra has got two potentially endangered endemic shrubs. They are known as Crotalaria, and this is a small shrub here. There are two names here you find them. One is Crotalaria subfruticosa, and the second one is Crotalaria multibractiata. It's very difficult for me to speak these scientific words. Anyways, I will give it one more try. Crotalaria multibracetiata, right? Multibracetiata. I practiced it many times, but then as well, this, you know, I have a very raw discussion with you guys. It's not scripted, so I hope you will forget me because it's Sunday. Now, new species of water strider has been found in this Nagaland River. Zoological Survey of India has found this thing in Nagaland River. The name of the river is Intanki. See, this mistake is taking over me, and it is Sunday as well. Sorry about that. You have this species. The name is Pilomera. Nagalanda, and one name is Jehamalar, and the second one is Chandra. In our country, when we talk about this subgenus Pilomera, then we have this five species. So this one is a new one. So these are important new species and important things. Many a times you find this sort of questions because of climate change and other things that are going on. So high chances you find this type of things. Difficult to pronounce, but easy to remember. And if you are finding it difficult, then you have this picture as well. Go through it many times, but do remember this sort of names. I don't want you guys to lose any single mark, particularly on those things that we have discussed about. With this, dear friends, these are your questions. The answer is Cliff. I'm still waiting for your answer on this descriptive question that was presented to you yesterday. And don't forget to check out studyiq.com. Enjoy your Sunday. Make the most out of this festival season as well. Make the most out of the discount that you are getting on our Pendrive and Tablet courses. You can share your greetings with me in the comment section. If you have learned something from today's discussion, then please do give us your like. Pass word about what we do here, what we discuss here with your friends. Do conduct a discussion, right, offline, online, on the things that we discuss, and this will help you a lot. It will help you a lot. Just take out 10-15 minutes maybe, right, and throw some questions around, share something with your friends. You have some wonderful people who do contribute every day, so be a part, be a sport of it. Don't leave it on someone else, because it is about your growth and your education. Thank you very much for being with me, for listening to me on a regular basis, providing all this motivational encouragements on a regular basis. It helps a lot. Trust me, it helps a lot. So thank you very much. God bless you all. Enjoy your Sunday. God bless our country. Jai Hind.